There we are, back at the Vatopedi Monastery, part 2. This is the big pond. It's going really well. There's a lot of improvement. And we're going to fit an extra UV system, the bio-UV. It was already planned, but we had to wait for the manufacturer. Case stayed, but his beard won't grow, so he's going to come with me back home after we finish the small pond. So this is the small pond, 47 ton. Also same style as the big pond. They have only 63 millimeter bottom drains, and also the returns are 63. So we had to adjust it, and in this pond it was possible to make 3 110 holes. So two of them are going to be side drains, and one is going to be the skimmer. So the left skimmer is going to go, and there's going to be a new skimmer on the end. So that's going to be the whole thing. And over there, it's a bit lower, 20 centimeters lower than where I'm standing now. So all the dirt will go that way. The cable you see is for the electricity of the pump for the bucky shower, or the two bucky showers, also attached to the wall like the big pond, and camouflaged with the stickers. A lot of rocks will go. So back at the filter system, you can see they already placed the moving bed. It's almost as big as the big pond moving bed, only it's a bit less wide. It's 90 centimeters wide. This is the place where the sand filter used to be. So you can see we've got some lines coming in and out. This is the place where the bio-UV will be installed. Yeah, so this is the giant moving bed. And the on the right you can see the drum filter, the 5055 XL. On this side of the drum filter we have the three incoming pipes, 110 mil, coming into the in the drum filter. It has standard four pipes in, but we could only do three. The red orangey pipe is the drain of the big pond, and we can also use that for the small pond. The filter is not yet in line. It has to be, of course, straight in line with the moving bed. We're gonna adjust it later. So the drum filter is connected to the moving bed filter. It's really easy with the rubber manchettes and just a small piece of PVC. Really well. Now we're gonna go for the incoming lines of the drum filter. But first. Nico's here. There's a giant coming, really strong man. He can help us with getting all the, not all, but most stones, rocks out of the pond. Yeah, it has to be safe for the koi, and we don't want the rocks to catch all the dirt. This side is also gonna go. And we're gonna adjust all the 63 incoming inlets. We're gonna adjust them so they will be as wide as possible. Good morning.
Ja, dag 2 echt voor de.
Day 2.
Voor de vijvers. We zijn de goederen die zouden eigenlijk vanochtend hier al zijn.
All the materials that have to come from Holland should be in this morning, but they're a bit delayed, so we're waiting for the materials for the connection of the filter. So we're gonna do a lot of stuff in the pump itself.
De pompen natuurlijk, dat is helemaal belangrijk. Dus we kunnen nu nog wat kleine dingetjes, kleine, maar wel essentiële dingen doen. Het flow systeem aanpassen, want dat
we're gonna adjust the flow system. Get rid of the skimmer.
Die rare skimmer daar. En er staat een heel klein. Nee, de linker, hè? Dus de linker skimmer. De skimmer waar Kees nu mee bezig is. En er zit daar een gaatje erin gezet. Dat kan met een aanzaagpomp van 2,5 kilowatt. Nou, is ook niet goed, maar daar kan het mee. Maar dan heb je helemaal geen aanzaag. Dus we hebben.
We are adjusting this because with the 2.5 kilowatt hour pump, it's possible to do it with the small pipes, but we want to save as much energy as possible. I'm going to show you. This is the old system.
They
just made a hole, maybe 25 mil. I just can put my index finger in. So that's really a shame for the flow. We got rid of those. When Kees is finished with the skimmer, we're gonna adjust the side range and install the new skimmer. This was the only place where we could drill some holes in the wall, so that's why they're there, but the floor is quite a bit lower on that side, so all the dirt will be going that way.
And that wordt een leiding zodat het water wordt opgestoven, meer circuleert.
There will also be a 70,000 liter pump in the pond, just like a flow pump. It's going to be installed underneath the stone, so no one will see it, but there will be a big flow that will make sure all the dirt will go also to the side where Kees is at the moment.
En dan komen we nog twee bakkie showers.
En of course the two bakkie showers before the materials come, so we can still go on.
Hoeveel jaar zou deze muur zijn? Nou, een paar honderd.
Ik denk dat die in 1300 toch eerder gebouwd is.
Ja, 1300 is die muur gebouwd. En daar hebben wij een paar handtekeningen voor binnen moeten krijgen. Maar we mogen boren. Dus, nou, we zijn al, Kees en ik zijn al aan het vechten wie erin een hele oude muur mag boren. Dit is de tank.
This is the moving bed.
Een heel mooi rooster in, maar er zitten nu nog 3-4 keer 110
It's same as the big pond, so we have to cover it with mesh. So the moving bed is not gonna get into the pump and eventually back into the pond.
So we're gonna
cover that and we're gonna attach the air discs on the frame that is about 20 centimeters above the bottom. We want the flow to be from the top to the bottom for the water, and the air of course from down to the top, so the water and the air will collide.
Okay. Adieu.
Adieu.
Bye, Kees.
Je zei die gaan sterven groeten.
Een woord dat je niet zo vaak hoort. Adieu.
Stay alive. So Kees is now making the mesh. You see the gray pipe with all the holes and also the mesh on the end. That's for the actual pump. And the other three are just covered with some with the mesh just on top, because if they're gonna be used, they're gonna be small pumps. We're on our way to the harbor. Father Rafael is driving, and many people are going to help us to unload the boat, all the filters, the helix, pumps, and all other material are going to be collected, so we can carry on with installing the filter system. It's a bumpy ride, and you can see Father Rafael is also excited, so he's driving a bit faster than normal.
Yeah, this is not the boat.
This is not the boat. It's a really big boat.
This is the moving bed material, the white bags. It's so good. Coming.
You can see the boat coming
already
in the distance.
Yeah, driving. Yeah, good.
So we're in time.
Yeah.
There he is. I hope they're gonna unload on the back side and not on the front side. The black bags is filled with the helix, the bucky showers, the bi-UV two times, the plastic plants. The other drum filters are delivered at the garden center. This is the pump. Flow Friend Junior. The pump is already connected, and normally we would do 110 mil, but we couldn't, so now 63. But I think it will work really fine. Tomorrow we're gonna connect this bi-UV. Bi-UV has not only the work for the getting rid of the algae, but also lower the amount of bacteria and parasites and viruses.
Als je niet alleen algen wil bestrijden, maar ook bacteriën, eencellige wormen, dan gaat het fantastisch.
Voor mij betreft het de veilige ozon variant.
It's a good solution if you don't want ozon. This is really safe and has the same outcome.
Maar ook daarboven de stickers van de bakjes aan. Zo gaan we even kijken.
Kees is already busy with the bucky showers and it really looks good. Okay, we can start filling the pond. You can see it's really hot at the moment. So even the steam is coming out of the hose. It's really hot. You can see right away the floor is not leveled, so the water is going that way. So it's quite a bit lower at that end than at the other end. It's going to take a while to fill this pond, but in a few hours it will be ready. While the pond is filling up, we're going to put in the UV, the extra UV, so we have the bio-UV and the normal Omegan UV. And we can start it up. So now the water level is coming up. The pump is not running yet, so it's not on yet. So now the water level will come almost all the way to the edge. In the drum filter, they have a line where the level should be, and you can see we're really, really well. It's going up still, so it's going to end at the level. Exactly to the edge, but if the pump is running, the level in there will be much lower, so there's no problem. Now you can see it's really, really set on the level. Let me explain why I like the Red Label drum filters. First of all, the Red Label team service is magnificent. If there's something broke, or they will always help you send material if you're really far away, and if they're in the neighborhood, then they're gonna come and save you. Then the filter itself, it's really well welded. So it's really a tough filter system. You must imagine that drum is turning, let's say 2, 3, 4 times an hour, years and years. And if the welds are not good enough, or if the material is not strong enough, it will get out of shape, and that's really not good for a drum filter. I'm gonna put the drum on. Or the display on, that means the pump is on and everything is on. Now it says stop. Oh, yeah, starts up now. And then you should be able to see this. Yeah, that level is now lowering. And the pump is running really well. By pushing the number 5 about 5, 6, 7, 8 times, the bypass switch is activated. So normally if you have the lid off the drum filter, it doesn't work. But with that switch going off, we can work on it, and still the filtration system is working. Because it's really clean, it didn't turn, but I put it now on manual. So the spray sprayed the dirt from the screen to the cutter to the waste, and it really works well. Kees is gonna swim. He's gonna have a look for his chewing gum. Now I'm gonna put on the pump. It's already on, but not all valves are closed yet. The valves without the hoses. So I'm gonna close them, and then in a while, it takes a few seconds, maybe half a minute, before the moving bed is really moving well. You must imagine this is already 1,300 liter of Helix. Almost. One, two. And almost. UVs are on. I want to see that the whole moving bed is moving, and it is now. It's really moving well. UVs are on. Don't look at the UV without the special glasses. You can see the current going on. One time rinsing. Oi, oi, oi. This is of course the dirt that was still in the pipes. Notice that I'm wearing my special glasses, UV 100% UV resistant glasses. Really important.
Now,
Kees is at the control system, control panel, and he's going to switch on the bakkie showers and the flow pump.
And ik ben benieuwd wat er gaat gebeuren als de stroom is voorbij.
I'm curious what happens when the flow starts. You can turn it on, Kees.
Bakkie showers natuurlijk.
Oh, bakkie showers. Look at the fake plants.
Ja.
Oh, look at that. Look at the current on the bottom. Really working well. Exactly what I wanted.
Hele bende weg. Dus dat is fantastisch.
That's fantastic. Bakkie showers. I hope they do it equally. Now the right is running really well, the left not yet, but I hope it comes. Yeah, there it comes. Yeah, really good. Wow. Look at the dirt on the floor. Because of the 70,000 liter pump, all the dirt will be blown to the side drains. And I'm really pleased with the result of the bakkie showers with the stickers, because this really looks good. The architect can be really proud.
We hebben er best lang over gedaan, want de planten zijn al tegen aangegroeid.
It took a while, the plants already grew on the filter system. First I thought, why stickers, but I'm really happy with this result. The left one is a bit blue, but a few days sun, it will all be the same color. It's really hot here in Greece. 8:30 in the evening and still really hot. I wanted to make a star trail tonight, but I can see the clouds coming up. You can see the dirt moving, so in about 1 or 2 hours all the dirt will be gone. Three weeks later. This is the next project. This is a smaller pond. We're now digging, but we've got some well water coming up, so they're gonna carry on.